My name is Ian Nelson, and I'm a student in the Department of Classical Near Eastern Studies, and I have a major in Religious Studies. The University of Minnesota actually has a fairly unique program in Classical Near Eastern Studies, in that we are trying to integrate the traditional classics department, which is the Greco-Roman literature with the influence of Persian or Hebrew and Near Eastern thought. This really works well for a student of religion because, for instance, early Christianity is precisely that. It's the importation of a Near Eastern Jewish religion into the Greco-Roman world and context. I've always been interested in the history and development of ideas, so I began at the university studying the history of philosophy. Through that, I was introduced to religious thought, which, like history of philosophy, studies intellectual exchange and the development and conflict of ideas. But unlike philosophy, actually has ground-level application. It actually affects the way people live their lives. And so I got really interested in the development of early Christianity and early Judaism. The literature and history of early Christianity is particularly interesting because of the diversity of sources we have. And so you have a limited number of sources as opposed to, say, World War II history, where there's no one can ever possibly read all the material that's out there. But you have enough things that you can see competing schools of thought and intellectual trajectories in the development of the religion. I was reading contemporary theologians, and they were making allusions to a figure named St. Augustine, who is a colossus of the ancient world. And St. Augustine was making allusions to Plato. And so I started reading Plato, and Plato was making allusions to Homer. So I began with reading Homer and tried to work my way forward through the history of thought, an impossible task. And understanding how schools of thought interact and how intellectual exchange and conflict work is incredibly useful, and that's something which the study of the history of religion and the study of history of classical thought really highlights.